Hi, welcome to AwkwardHamster. Today I'll be reviewing this Nixplay Edge 30-inch Wi-Fi cloud frame. And let me get straight to the pros and cons. First, the pro, the display is stunning. It's beautiful. It's full HD 1080p. Next, the type of the screen they're using is more of a matte finish. The base they're using is like a non-scratch type surface. So right now, I've placed this on top of my piano without any worry about scratching my piano surface. Setup was very easy. It takes about 5 minutes or less. And I can also manage everything online through their web interface. I can manage my albums, my playlist, manage the functionality on the frames. For example, how long to have the image show up for, when I have to fit onto the screen, whether I have it faded from one image to the next image. The view angle of the frame is also pretty impressive. Whether I'm viewing from either angle, left, right, top down, the clarity is extraordinary. It's stunning. Now let's talk about some of the cons. Right now I'm standing about almost 30 feet, 25 to 30 feet from the Nixplay Edge Wi-Fi frame. And for this remote control, if I press like home button, for example, it doesn't register it. If I stand somewhere closer to about 20 to 25 feet, if I keep pressing it, every now and then it'll register. So now it just changed. But to get an accurate response from the remote control, I can stand about 10 feet or so. Now anything, every time I press something, it will definitely register. Another con is the way Nixplay Edge handles the pictures taking either portrait or landscape. So currently these pictures are landscape, basically means it's longer left and right. So I can see all the objects or the highlights or the people inside the images. But for images that are taking portrait mode, basically taller from up and down, it scans from the bottom to the top. But currently my transition is set to once every 10 seconds. So if the 10 seconds are up, it's going to move on to the next image regardless or not it actually viewed the upper half of that picture. And that's pretty annoying. And that brings me to my next con. For where I go to upload my images to the album, I can rotate the images 90 degrees, but there's no option here for me to crop the images. And if Nixplay has a limitation on basically only showing images that's like taken in the portrait mode better than pictures taken in landscape mode, I need to give the clients the opportunity to crop the image just so that it can better fit the screen. Now, another con is if there is a limitation for the transition. So if I had set to 10 seconds before it transitions to next image, it'll go up to my son's feet. If I set to 30 seconds, it'll go up to his nose area. And regardless of whether or not it shows the full image, it would just move on to next picture. So what they should have done is for the pan speed, when it goes from the bottom to the top, at least have the pan speed match the transition time. So if the transition time is 10 seconds, have the pan speed from the bottom to the top be 10 seconds. It won't move to the next image until it shows the full picture. Though the screen has a beautiful resolution of 1080p, they put a limitation on the video format it supports. So for video, it only supports up to 720p, and that just doesn't make much sense. Adding the Wi-Fi to this cloud frame is very easy if you know what Wi-Fi is. But let's say you don't, let's say you're my parents and you're trying to add this at their house. Well, what they would appreciate is if there were a WPS button on the back of this to easily sync with their wireless router. So after listening to all those pros and cons, it comes down to whether or not I'll recommend this. And the answer to that is it really depends. For example, I will get this for my parents, but I will not get it for myself. I'm willing to spend $300 for my parents, but not for myself. It's because for them, I can just set it up at their house and then manage the pictures remotely, manage the albums, manage a playlist, and they'll love it. The quality of this, the screen resolution, 1080p, beautiful, stunning, excellent viewing angles, matte finish screen. It's hard to find a picture frame out there that has this kind of build quality. Now, it is $300. It's very expensive. There are some shortcomings with the way they handled portrait pictures, the way it pans from one image to another image. So it's a lot of the shortcomings has to do with software, and hopefully Nixplay can address them, such as, for example, being able to play 720p video on here, not 1080p, when this is a 1080p display. Well, thanks for watching this review of the Nixplay Edge 13-inch Wi-Fi cloud frame. If you guys have any questions, comments, suggestions, feel free to contact me. Thanks for watching, Walker Hamster. Bye.